This class is called Bio-Inspired Robotics, but we actually teach the differences between biology and robotics.
The duality of bio-inspired robotics really emphasizes that having a reference for something that works and has been kind of vetted through natural selection is really valuable in terms of coming up with an idea that you might not be able to otherwise.
The idea is not necessarily to copy what we see in nature verbatim, but to understand why certain designs have evolved in nature.
I think the ultimate goal of my class is actually to learn how human works, because it's impossible to build the machine that can help us without understanding how we work.
So the assignment is essentially to choose a dynamic system and try to extract the biological principles.
Whoa! Whoa!
I think this year is one of the best years. There was a gymnastics robot, chicken robot, jumping robot, there was a hula hoop robot, and there's a throwing robot, and there's a punching robot.
I lovingly call it Mike Tyson. And what we wanted to explore was how the mass distribution on the forearm and the upper arm segments would actually affect the momentum output.
Our group project was a kangaroo bot, but it was basically a single degree of freedom jumping leg that would jump on a trampoline.
Our project is called SuniBot, based off of Suni Lee, who is a USA gymnast. The core component of the project is to understand how gymnasts swing up on the uneven arms.
We built like a small bipedal walker that was running on a boom, affectionately known as the ChickenBot 9000. We found the chicken head made the walker 300% cuter.
Through our simulations and our hardware experiments, we discovered that when you swing up as a gymnast, there's two different phases. And so it is this very dynamic, fast-paced action.
Going through my like everyday life, I kind of noticed it more, where the speeds that I walked would change how I walked. So it was kind of nice to see how that all aligned.
I boxed for about 7-ish years. Now I know where to put all my mass. And it's in the tip of the boxing gloves, obviously.
In the class, you're consciously doing this trade-off of, do I really need a bio-inspired system to solve this problem? In some cases, the answer is yes, right? But in some cases, the answer is no.
You don't need to constrain yourself into the biomimicry field. You know, we're talking about bio-inspired robotics, not biomimicry robotics. So if there's an easier way to do in robotics, just don't be shy about it.
When you look at animals, I always wonder now, why are they walking the way that they are? Why are they moving the way that they are? Is that just coincidental, or is there some strategy that they're employing to minimize energy or to be extra fast?